Hello students, today we are going to study one of the parts of speech, that is preposition. Earlier we have studied noun, verb, adjective and adverb. Now in this video we are going to study about the definition of preposition, list of preposition and sentences based on preposition. Very simple way, preposition means it's a word, it's one of the parts of speech. You can consider a word or phrase that connects or joins a noun or pronoun to a verb or adjective in a sentence. I'll read definition once again and I'll explain you. A preposition is a word or phrase that connects a noun or pronoun to a verb or adjective in a sentence. Now in a simple language, preposition means it's a word which joins noun or pronoun or verb or adjective in a sentence. Suppose there is a sentence which begins with the noun or pronoun, whatever it is, and it is connected by preposition. For example, I'll say the cat is in the kitchen. Where is the cat? In the kitchen. In is the preposition. The boy walked out. So here out is the preposition. Where the boy walked out. Is it clear? So the word which connects noun, pronoun, adjective or verb in a sentence is called a preposition. Now you may get confused when you read the definition, but when you look at the sentences and the list of preposition, you will get idea what is preposition. Let us move to the list of preposition. Now here I have given the preposition list. Now you can see the word begins with A, B, in, whatever it is, different alphabet. Okay, alphabetical letter. Now first about, above, according to, across, after, against, ahead of, along, amidst, among, because of, before, behind, below, beneath, beside, besides, between, beyond, by. Now all these in the chart, whatever the words are present, they are preposition. There are many prepositions. As you study more and more, you will get the idea. These are all simple prepositions. Let us move to the another list of. Now these are the common prepositions which we used in day-to-day life. Okay. Every day we come across the preposition. About. I would like to know about that person. I kept the things above. Okay. Then after. He came after the lunch. The boy is against his friend. All these are words. You can frame the sentence of your own. I'm going to take it also. Now you can just, you have to write the definition, understand it and write all the prepositions whichever I have given. Put the date. Date is very, very important. Sorry. Now here, I have given some examples of common prepositions used in sentences to make the concept clear. For example, he sat on the chair. Now question arises, where he sat? On the chair. So on is the preposition. I'll explain you a few examples. There is some milk in the fridge. Where is the milk? In the fridge. So in is the preposition. She was hiding under the table. Now here, where she is hiding? Under the table. So under is the preposition. Now next example, the cat jumped off the counter. So off is the preposition. Now dear students, the words which I have highlighted with the red color, they are all prepositions. Got it? The common preposition which we use when we speak, when we write. Is it clear? Like this way, I have near about 24 sentences to understand. Now this is the next clip, here also from 13 to 24 sentences, total 24 sentences I have given you, and the highlighted words are all preposition. Now see, very simple, we are running. Now here two parts of sentences are joined. Running is a verb, after verb preposition in is come, isn't it? Now the sun is noun, is above is preposition. She lives near her workplace, lives is a verb, near is preposition. Preposition in a simple word, it is a connecting word. Preposition which connects noun, verb, adjective in a sentence. So my dear students, understand the prepositions, write the definition and write the list of the preposition. Any doubt, once again I'm telling you, write down the doubts properly so that I can explain you when we have class in personally. Okay, that means when we are going to have a class, that time I'm going to clear your each and every doubt regarding the syllabus. But one thing you have to do, you have to write all the work which I give. I have given the papers to solve, that you have to complete in the notebook only. Tomorrow in the next video we are going to solve, identify the preposition from the sentences. Step by step we are going to study. So thank you dear students, thank you for the cooperation. I hope you will understand clearly. Once again I will tell you, if there is any doubt, please write it down. I will help you. Thank you. Have a nice day. Take care. Bye.